Hello stars, it's me Aaron. Normally I would make this video outside because I've definitely been enjoying making outdoor TSG videos, but I have some catching up to do with homework, so I'm just gonna definitely give this topic the attention it deserves and continue on with my day. This topic was chosen by Morgan C. and the author is Kate. Have you had experiences with coming out as trans to someone else who to someone who has a cookie cutter definition of a trans person that you don't exactly fulfill? How do you deal with friends, family, or strangers' preconceptions of what trans is when they don't match up with how you feel about your trans identity? This topic definitely applies to me because I deal with this often, and in the very beginning of my transition, I was definitely thinking that I wanted to just be seen as a trans woman and as a woman, and that's all I wanted. But as I continued on, the queer side of me has become stronger and is fighting back. And that queer side of me is very androgynous and wants access to both spaces and to both opposite sides of the binary. I'm very much so in between and enjoy that access to both spaces. So when I'm coming out, I may not always use the word transgender. If I do, I talk about being queer and being androgynous and ambiguous or feeling that way, you know, on the inside. And when I come out to friends, family, or strangers, I don't do too much of that, to be honest with you. I did come out to some friends, and I think they passed the word along, and I visited a lot of friends recently who used female pronouns for me, and it felt great. I don't think my family understands too much yet. When it comes to strangers, when they ask me what gender pronouns I prefer, I tend to say play with them because I'm not trying to pass right now as a woman, so it's not so important to me, or as a man. And when it comes to people that do see transgender people and they really want to know, about what being transgender means, I feel like they tend to definitely see that cookie cutter definition. And from those people who want to help, I tend to feel that pressure to fulfill that cookie cutter definition and to that preconception and to that conception that they're developing. And I'm supposed to help, represent, right? Represent the trans community. And I have a hard time doing that as a very queer trans person. I may just come out as transgender and not tag it with being either a woman or male or a man. Sometimes that is satisfying for me, but I feel like I definitely get treated as like a cis person when I come out as a trans woman to someone who wants to see trans people. They'll try to treat me like I'm cisgender, which I don't like because I'm not, and I don't want to be seen that way personally. So I definitely do not fit into that cookie cutter definition. And I hope a lot of trans people don't fit into that cookie cutter definition because I don't think it's accurate. I think that it's being perpetuated, and I think that it's damaging to personal identities and to trans people being very, very diverse in our gender definitions. And I just don't think that we should be, what are you putting the cisgender gender on a pedestal? Obviously, that's a term that we're using to just describe, other people, but I think it's also when put into that, when we're talking about this cookie cutter definition of what it means to be transgender, it kind of means like understanding how that person wants their gender to be, and that's usually either a man or woman, and treating them as that, how it's been socially treated always, treating them as normal and dismissing the weirdness of being transgender, apparently. Because that's just too weird for people to handle. So, I mean, I hope I'm making sense here, but that's pretty much all I have to say. I have stuff to do, so. But I definitely think I talked about this as well as I could, so if I'm not really making sense, you can ask me more questions in the comments below if there's some curiosity about the language I'm using or, the ideas that I'm kind of spewing out right now because I'm definitely saying a lot. When it comes to coming out, though, I just don't do a lot of coming out lately. I definitely still come out in other ways, and that's, you know, communicating with my appearance and with the way I use my words and everything like that. So it's definitely hard to work with other people who may not understand what it means to have a very different transgender identity, very different from that of what is being perpetuated, I guess. I don't know. That's all I have to say. Goodbye, everybody.